Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Wherever you are, we invite you to enter into worship with us as we prepare for the word this morning. We're excited to be coming to you once again. One more time. The Lord has joined us together. One more time. We come to you declaring healing. There's healing in the land. Even in the midst of the confusion, people are trying to find a solution, trying to find a vaccine, trying to find a cure. Even in the midst of the confusion, we came to tell you this morning that we know the cure. That vaccine, that cure is Jesus Christ. We came to tell you this morning. Bible readers know what we're talking about. There is a balm in Gilead. That vaccine, that cure is Jesus Christ. There's healing for your soul. Wherever you are. Everybody's been going through with this situation. Just lift your hands and thank God for being that healer that we need right now. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah. There's healing for your sorrow, healing for your pain. Healing for your spirit. There's shelter from the rain. Launching your healing. For this we know that there's a balm in Gilead. Hallelujah. If you know what I'm talking about, lift your hand. There is a balm in Gilead. He's healing right now. If you want him to, y'all. There is a balm in Gilead. Anybody know what I'm talking about? If you know the healer. Put all of your faith in him. How many believe it? Ooh, there is a bomb in Gilead. If you're in the hospital right now, if you're at home, if you're isolated, if you're quarantined, Jesus is that bomb in Gilead. How many believe that out there? How many know he's a healer? How many know he's a deliverer? He is the healer. He is the answer. You don't have to look any farther. Jesus is waiting on you right now. Reach out, for there is a bomb in Gilead. There's a bomb in Gilead. Hallelujah. Bomb in Gilead. Jesus is waiting up. There is a bomb. Hallelujah. Oh. Your body can't be healed till your soul is healed. Healing for your soul. He's waiting on you. Healing for your soul. Just lift your hands wherever you are. That's healing for your soul. Somebody needs to hear that this morning. That's healing for your soul. Yes. That's healing for your soul. Yes. Hallelujah. Healing for your soul. I dare you say that with us this morning. That's healing for your soul. Yes, God. That's healing for your soul. Hallelujah. Healing for your soul. Your soul. There is none like you. No one else can touch my heart like you do. Somebody know what I'm talking about. Hallelujah. Oh, there is none like you. No one else can touch my heart like you do. I don't know about y'all, but I've searched all over for eternity, Lord, but I found out there is none like you. Somebody needs to hear that. Wherever you are, come on, worship him. Oh, there is none like you. God, we thank you this morning because we know you are the solution. Hallelujah. No one else can touch my heart like you do. Ooh, yeah. I can search for all eternity, Lord, and find out there. Nobody like you. 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 I can search for all eternity long. There is none like. There is none. Ooh. There is none like.
From the book of Romans, chapter number 12, verse 1 and verse 2. We're going to read it this morning out of the NLT version. I think it should be on your screen at this moment. Romans chapter 12, verse 1 and verse 2. And it reads, "And so, dear brothers and sisters, I plead with you to give your bodies to God, and it reads, because of all he has done for you. Let them be a living and holy sacrifice, the kind he will find acceptable. This is truly the way to worship him." I'm going to read that again. "And so, dear brothers and sisters, I plead with you to give your bodies to God because of all he has done for you. Let them be a living and holy sacrifice, the kind he will find acceptable. This is truly the way to worship him." Verse 2, and we'll conclude. It says, "Don't copy the behavior and the customs of this world, but let God transform you into a new person by changing the way you think. Then you will learn to know God's will for you, which is good and pleasing and perfect." This is the will of the Lord. This is the word of the Lord on this morning. We're going to work from the topic, "Don't settle, go be great." Don't settle, go be great. As we conclude this April series, Pick Up Your Cross, part 3. Don't settle. Go be great. And as I launch off into the deep waters of this text and place this message in the hands of the Lord, our journey has brought us to this stopping point in this series, Pick Up Your Cross, which will conclude with this sermon titled, "Don't Settle, Go Be Great. My brothers and sisters, within Romans, the 12th chapter, we find that the Apostle Paul now adds practical application and personal greetings to his theological discussion of chapters 1 through 11. In fact, people of God, this book of Romans may be divided into two large sections, doctrine, which is chapters 1 through 11, and application, chapters 12 through 16. Two large sections, doctrine, chapter 1 through 11, and application, chapters 12 through 16. Yes, in light of this great plan of salvation, which was laid out in 1 through 11, particularly when he talks about all the mercies or benefits, this book, it brings us to a point where we have to understand that our surrender to God is required. But today, in this chapter, people of God, we find a new challenge. Today, in this chapter, we find a new challenge. Our cross carrying today it involves responding appropriately to the salvation that we all have received. I hope you're paying attention today. I hope you're listening close. Our responsibility is responding appropriately to the salvation we all have received. I need to talk to somebody today. We owe everything to God. We owe everything to God. And every day that we pick up our cross, our job is to be better. Say it all the time, that we need to be better today than we were yesterday. We need to be better. We need to be better this week than we were last week. We need to be better this month than we were last month. We need to be better this year than we were last year. If we're going to carry our cross every day, we should be determined to be better. Yes, greatness comes when we give ourselves as living sacrifices to God. Yes, cross carrying. Here it is. It's a day-to-day job. Yes, cross carrying is a day-to-day offering. Yes, cross carrying is a day-to-day sacrifice before God. It's a process that reason. Walk, we should be great when it comes. Great, our light walking towards God should be
great. You see, this passage of scripture, it contains strong exhortation. And without a shadow of a doubt, this text urges total devotion. This text reminds us that cross carrying is a sacrifice. Normal. I believe God is calling Christians to get their houses in order as we prepare for what will become our new normal. I believe that God is calling Christians to get their houses in order. We need to be leaders that lead correctly. I need to talk to somebody in this place, and somebody on Facebook, and somebody on YouTube, and somebody that's watching us on our live stream, and let you know that we can't live in the dark and live in the light at the same time. See, the light of Christ, it should not be dimmed, and sin got to be wiped out. I need somebody to be committed to wiping out sin, that sin should be wiped out. I need to tell somebody today, there is no room for sin in our lives. See, great people can't carry sin and the cross at the same time. I wish somebody would hear what I'm saying. Great people can't carry sin and crawl in the cross at the same time. Not if you're practicing clean living. And not if your efforts are to make it to heaven. I need to tell somebody today, dedication to God in this text is strongly suggested. This chapter connects all the previous discussions that have happened in the book of Romans. And it talks about what it takes to get us right and what it takes to get right. And in the early chapters, it talks about what it will take to keep us right. Follow me, if you will, in Romans 1. Chapter 1 verse 18 through chapter 3 verse 20, it discusses the fact that the world desperately needs to get right with God. Romans chapter 3 from verse 21 through chapter 5 verse 21, it discusses the way of the world, and that the world can only get right through Jesus. When we believe in Jesus, the Bible says that God counts our faith as righteous. Romans the 6th chapter, from verse 1 through the 8th chapter and verse 39, it discusses that when we believe in Jesus, we can be sanctified, we can be set apart, we can be set free from sin, and we can be given life eternal. Yeah, Romans chapter 9 from verse 1 through chapter 11 and verse 36, it explains that we are now God's choice, and that we've been chosen to carry the gospel of Jesus throughout the whole world. See, my brothers and my sisters, God has deposited within us a glorious, great message that displays how much he loves us and explains everything he has done for us and everything he will do for us in the future. This is what is meant when it says the mercies of God. See, God's mercies are new every day, and God's mercies are overflowing, meaning that they are beyond anything that we can ever desire. Just think about it, and I'm going to move. God has given us a way to get right with him. When he gave us Jesus, yes, God has prepared power to set us free. Set us free from bondage, and he's doing it through Jesus. Yes, God has given us a glorious purpose to tell the world how to be set free from sin. And it's through Jesus. Here we go. Because of the mercies of God and all that he has done for us, we should make a sacrifice. And we should carry our cross. Yes, here it is. We should devote ourselves to God. Beloved, we must dedicate and commit ourselves to God day after day. Dedication and commitment, it leads to greatness. I'm moving, but look at here. Note the words in verse 1 where it says, I beseech you. In the Greek, that word is parakaleo, meaning I implore you, or I urge you, or I beg you. It's important to understand, people of God, that we were created and we were called to be great people. We were created and called to be great people. And that's why... That's why we find here that the apostle is saying, I beseech you, I implore you, I urge you, I beg you. See, we need to understand that Christians can't be great in America. America is where we're stationed, but we belong to a different country. Y'all not seeing that America is where we live, but we belong to a greater kingdom. And because this land is not our home, we need to understand that we shouldn't be preparing to be great in America. We ought to be preparing to be great in heaven. See, this is a significant point that what is being said here in this text when he says, I beseech you, brothers and sisters. What he's saying is that what he was not talking to a lost world. No, he was talking to his brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ. When he says, I beseech you, brethren, he's saying that devotion to God is strongly urged. When he's saying, I beseech you, brothers, he's saying that our sacrifice and our cross-carrying is strongly urged. That our sacrifice and our cross-carrying it should be given, we should be giving ourselves to God. Spirit, body, and soul. We should be giving ourselves to God. I'm going to move a little bit further, but I will move. Our mission, our motive is to give our bodies to God. Matter of fact, God demands it in the scripture. He said that we ought to give him our spirit and our body. We got to understand that there is nothing about us that we own. There is nothing about us that we own. Our job is to choose God over everything. Yeah, our job is to choose God over our possessions. Our job is to choose God over our material wealth. Our job is to choose God over everything. It's our job to give ourselves to him. I think you see it this way. My life is not my own. To him, I belong. I give myself. It's our job today to rededicate ourselves to God. And look at here what he says. You got to do it while you're alive. I hope today that this message will encourage someone to make a living sacrifice. What are you saying, Delaney? A living sacrifice, one that is constant, one that is continuous, not just one that is occasional. Somebody need to hear that. One that is constant, one that is continuous, one that is not occasional. We shouldn't treat God like a fair weather friend. We shouldn't be Indian givers. When it comes to our service to God, we don't need to give our lives to him today and to take it back tomorrow. Our job is to live for God and keep on living for God. Once you give your life to him, you shouldn't decide tomorrow I'm going to practice with the devil. Once you give your life to him, You shouldn't decide tomorrow I'm going to go back and have fun in the world. When you decide for God I live and for God I die, you shouldn't decide tomorrow I'm going to hold up on that and I'm going to do something else. I need you to understand that it's a day by day journey. Wherever we may be, we must live a life that's holy and righteous and pure and clean and moral. We got to live it before God. See, don't get it twisted. A lot of us, we only put on and play church for people. Ouch, Delaney. We only put on and play church for other people. And we serve God after. We serve people first. And we serve God after. But I'm going to tell you today, this text is saying don't live for the people. You got to live for God. Don't live for the world. You got to live for the kingdom. I'm trying to move this thing. We shouldn't let the world pollute us. We shouldn't let the world dirty us. We shouldn't let the world contaminate us. We shouldn't let the world fill us with sin and corruption. It's time not to give in to the world. It's time not to settle for the world. It's time for us not to give in, here it is, to the lusts of the flesh and the lusts of the eyes and to the pride of life. No, beloved, we should live for God and be dedicated to follow him as he commands. See, carrying your cross, it means serving God at all costs. And when we do this, the Bible says greatness will follow. We need to live lives as sacrifices. We need to live lives as sacrifices. Yeah, lives live as sacrifices. The Bible says it will be acceptable and it will be well-pleasing in God's sight. And anything God is pleased with, he goes ahead and blesses. I need somebody to hear that. Yeah, lives lived as sacrifices will be acceptable and well-pleasing in God's sight. And anything God is pleased with, God is gonna bless. I'm gonna linger right here. Lives lived as sacrifices will be full of joy, full of rejoicing as we dedicate ourselves to live in the light for him. I need to tell somebody, you ought to make a declaration as you rededicate yourself. I can't give in to sin. I can't give in to sin. I can't give in to sin because I'm trying to be great. I can't give up where I am. I can't keep doing the same old things. I have to make up my mind that I'm going to be great. Yes, people of God, our move should be to make God happy with our choice to live right. Here it is. Here's my shift. This sacrifice, this cross carrying, if we carry it the right way, our lifestyle should be to worship God. Yes, greatness is found in our worship to God. You live different when you worship him. You walk different when you worship him. You carry yourself different when you realize that the way I live is worship unto God. You treat people different when you realize the way you live is worship unto God. You walk different when you realize the way you live, it brings worship to God. I wonder how many people out in Facebook, how many people off in YouTube, how many people online realize that my life that I live is to worship
God, there it is. I see my exit. Greatness is not conforming to the world. Greatness is not giving in to sin. Greatness is not fashioning ourselves after people. Greatness is not following after the devil. Greatness is not following after the crowd. Greatness is not pleasing the world, but greatness is serving God. Greatness is following Him. Greatness is doing what He commands. There it is. Greatness is living from the inside out. When God takes over me, when God start moving through me, when God is at hand, I'm renewed, I'm refreshed, I'm revived day after day. There it is. I find greatness in Jesus. I find greatness in the Father. I find greatness in the Son. So as I leave on this morning, as I move out on today, I wonder how many people of God is ready to pick up your cross and press towards a marker. I wonder as I move how many people will actually rededicate your life to God. Put Him first. Follow Him. Put Him first. Seek after Him. Put Him first. Walk with Him. Put Him first. Talk with Him. Put Him first. Believe in Him. Put Him first. Believe His word. Put Him first. Treat others like He treats you. As I move, how many people will put the kingdom before the world? I need you to know if you're committed, if you're dedicated, if you're sold out, you ought to walk in the light, live right, do right, walk right, talk right. Don't settle for second best. Don't settle for the scrap. Don't settle for the world. Give me Jesus. Everything else can wait. Give me Jesus. I hope I'm not too late. Is there anybody that can say, give me Jesus? Give me Jesus. The wheel in the middle of a wheel. Jesus, my horse pawing in the valley. Jesus, everything that I need and more. I don't want the world. I want the kingdom. My sacrifice, my service, my cross is Jesus. What He does, I will do. What He said, I will say. My life is not my own. My life is not my own, but Jesus. Where He sent, Jesus. What He said, Jesus. What He do for God, I live for God. I'll die, I'll serve Him for the rest. I'll serve Him for the rest. Ow! I'm
trying to leave it alone. I'm trying to let it go. But when I think of the goodness of God and all he does for me, my soul cries out, hallelujah, thank you, Jesus, Lord, you're worthy, you deserve the glory, yeah, 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 yeah.
Hallelujah, people of God. Hallelujah, people of God. Hallelujah. Whoo! I don't know about y'all, but I needed that release. I don't know about y'all, but I needed to just let go and have a moment of praise with God. Look, people of God, we don't take it for granted that everyone watching us, that everyone viewing us is saved. We don't take it for granted that everyone watching us and viewing us has a personal relationship with God. So at this time, we stand and offer you Jesus Christ. The virtual doors of the church is open. If you've never been baptized, you've never confessed with your mouth what you believe in your heart, you can come right now and give your life to God. You can give your life to Christ. Our minister over media, he's watching right now. He's viewing right now. And he'll make sure that we make contact with you if you want salvation, if you want to be saved. Right now, you can just very well just type on your screen, Lord, I need you to save me. I believe you are my Savior. I believe you are my King. I need you in my life. In this very moment, you can receive salvation. The Bible says if you confess with your mouth what you believe in your heart, at that very moment, you can be saved. Second call, second appeal is for rededication. Rededication. Someone may have already been baptized, may have already given your life to Christ. And for some strange reason, you stepped away. And you needed this sermon to get you back in focus to the point where you can give yourself back to God again. Rededication is available at this moment. All you got to do is repent. Tell the Lord you're sorry. And let him know you're ready to come back home. And at that very moment, at that very second, he'll welcome you back in to the fellowship like you have never left. Third appeal is for membership, fellowship. The Lord has spoken to your heart through this worship experience. You've been watching us now for some 7 to 8 weeks. And you believe that this type of praise, this type of worship, this type of word is just for you. Even though we may not be able to welcome you formally at this moment, we can welcome you right now on the screen. If you just need a church home, just you can just declare it right now. I want to be family. There it is. I want to be family. You can declare it right now. I want to be family. And someone will reach out to you. We're taking down that list. And as soon as this thing gets over, we'll be reaching out to you formally to welcome you in to our family. You don't just have to be in Gonzales, Geismar, or St. Gabriel. Wherever you may be, we're virtual now. And if you believe that this worship is for you, you can make your declaration, and we'll be sure enough happy to make contact. We are one family. Maybe you're saying, well, Pastor Delaney, I've been moved by this type of worship, but I know where I want to be. I know where I want to go. Look, I'm not concerned about numbers. I'm concerned about your relationship with Jesus Christ. We'll make sure you get wherever you need to be, wherever you want to go. You just make your statement, and we'll make sure that you get there. Is there one today for salvation, rededication, or membership? Here it is. This is how we do it inside the sanctuary. If you're saved and you know you're saved, let me see your hands. If you're on a virtual, just send us a wave. If you're saved and you know you're saved, let's see your hands. One more time, let me see your hands. And reply like this, thank you, God, for saving me. One more time, thank you, God, for saving me. God bless you. God keep you, is our prayer. Thank you, people of God, for worshiping with us today. Thank you, people of God, for worshiping with us today. We are so grateful. We're so thankful that you took time out of your schedule to be with us. You could have been doing anything at this very moment, Who would know? Not only you and God, but you decided to tune in, decided to fellowship with us. We thank you for those that are viewing us live and for those that are going to view us on replay. We pray that the Spirit of God be with you and bless you wherever you are. As we've been saying before, we're not requiring or mandating that you give during this season. But if the Lord has blessed you to be able to give in this season, we ask that you do it through Givelify. Through Givelify. One tap, you can give, and it's done. You can give mobily through your mobile giving device. You can give on your online through the computer or your iPad. All you have to do is download the Givelify app. One tap, you can give, and you're done. Maybe someone is not caught up on that yet. They might not be comfortable. You can mail your tithes and your offerings. If the Lord is still blessing you, to P.O. Box 448. P.O. Box 448, Gonzales, Louisiana, 70707. Amen. Amen. Hey, stay tuned to our website. I think coming up this week, the month is changing. We will have a new prayer guide. A new prayer guide for the month of May going out this week. A new prayer guide for the month of May. You can go to the news and events page where you can download that prayer app. As we move, as we leave, as we go, I want to tell you, take a moment to put a smile on your face, because God love you, Jesus has your back, and the Holy Spirit is in control. It's our declaration, this is our belief, that there is nothing, absolutely nothing, that will be able to hurt you, harm you, or hinder you this day. It's our prayer in closing. It's our belief. This is our statement of confidence that we all shall be healthy, happy, wealthy, and whole. Love you with the love of the Lord, and ain't nothing the devil can do about it. We encourage you to go in peace and sin no more. In Jesus' name, have a blessed day.